Hey, folks, we still have these flood warnings in effect for much of Hidalgo County, part of Cameron and Willacy counties. Until 8 o'clock tomorrow morning, they've been extended. That's for areas where we already have flooding. There's no new flooding, no new rain falling. In fact, this is radar. Notice there's not a drop of rain on there to be found, which is good. That's not to say there won't be another drop of rain or two, but the good news is that flash flood watch that was for everybody is gone. So no new flooding expected, just dealing with what we've been dealing with for the past few days. Now, future track suggests that we're mainly dry overnight. Could be a green dot or two show up during the daytime tomorrow. We're keeping the chance at about 20%, but it moves in, it moves out. It's not widespread, doesn't last long, and probably shouldn't create any new flooding, that's for sure. And then we go into tomorrow night. It's quiet during the daytime on Friday. Same kind of thing, partly sunny, hot, and humid with not much. I mean, it's a pretty much dry day across the area on Friday. And Saturday, we're keeping about a 20% chance in there. So really not much rain. If it starts to rain, it's going to move on. It's not going to last long. And then Friday is pretty much a dry day. And Saturday, for the most part, is dry as well. These are your current temperatures. And we're back in the upper 70s for a change, except in McAllen, Brownsville, and the island, where it's 80, 80, and 82. But upper 70s for pretty much everybody else. Tomorrow, we're climbing right back up into the low 90s again. Back above where we've been the last 4 or 5 days, 20% chance of an afternoon shower. The exception to the 90s will be the island at about 85 for your high tomorrow afternoon. The normal high is 97. We're going 92, then a couple of 94s, but we're staying below that seasonal average of 97. Really, all the way through the forecast period, we don't see it warming up much beyond that. Still an upper air disturbance kind of spinning. It's all the way back to the west of us now, and as it pulls westward, tries to pull up that last little bit batch of moisture during the daytime tomorrow, but after that, I think that goes away. A big trough in the middle part of the country, a dip in the jet stream, actually pushes the front into Texas. The front won't get here, but enough moisture around to maybe trigger a couple more showers, but nothing big as we head into the weekend. So your weekend forecast, 94 and 95 degrees for Saturday and for Sunday. Quick check of the tropics. We now have Tropical Storm Isaias that has formed. It finally became a tropical storm, expected to move across Haiti, Hispaniola, and then finally make its way west of the Bahamas. But after that, there's a lot of question marks about where it's going to go. But right now, the official forecast says it just kind of sideswiping the entire southeast coast of the U.S. If you want to see the spaghetti models, there's the Bermuda High. It goes right around. If that high strengthens, it would push it farther to the west. If it weakens, it would stay farther to the east. For tonight, then, 77. Could be a stray shower, but most areas are dry. Tomorrow, a spotty shower back up to 92 with winds out of the south to southeast. Here's your First 1-5 AccuWeather with a forecast for the next 7 days. Every day in the mid-90s, your rain chance very small all the way through the forecast period. Again, plenty of sunshine by the time we get to the weekend. That's your updated First 1-5 AccuWeather with a forecast.